Good evening all, just coming up to 6:15. I've been busy working today, very hard, on my new, guess what, yeah, tape recorder, and it's a blast from the past. And these machines, I'm going to show you now, this machine was manufactured between, I think it was 1963 to 67, and I've got one of the later ones. You want to see it? There we go. Look at that beast. It's another Revox. Revox are a Swiss tape recorder company. I'm not sure if they're still in business. I don't think so. But what a beast. This is a professional studio machine. Well, it's for the domestic, for the public really, but it's like really on par with studio quality. And I spent ages doing it up. I've still got to order a few more valves. It's got 12 valves, or as you say in the States, tubes, Rosie, if you're watching. 12 tubes, and I've got a few on order because the BIOS oscillator, that's the little circuitry that improves the quality of it. Early recorders didn't have biasing, but the Germans developed this biasing system that improved the quality of tape recorders. But anyway, I won't go into it. But I think the valve I've got on this one is a bit, or the tube is a bit weak, so I've ordered a few anyway. But what a beast, eh? Isn't it lovely, eh? Isn't she lovely? You want to hear it, I suppose. Yeah, all right. I'll get a copyright, but you know what? So what? Let's go. Here we go. What a beast of a machine. Oh, I love it. It's only going through shitty old speakers at the moment. Little technical rubbish. And a Chinese amp. Little Chinese amp. But it's all in the game. All in the wonderful game that we know as love. If I play this through decent speakers and a proper amp, it sounds so good. You have words with him. Don't say anything. Yeah. Where's my remote? And your future's looking thin. But these days your arts can rise above. Once in a while he will call, but it's all in the game. Soon he'll be there at your side with a sweet. I don't know if this video come out shaky. I haven't eaten much today, and my sugar levels dropped, and I get the shakes in my fingers, in my hands, whatever. So I hope it's not going to come out shaky. If not, I'll have to do it again. But there we go. Want to show you? Want to see the fast forward on this? It's unbelievable. I mean, look at that. This is only a test tape. This tape is from the 1960s. I mean, if I had to use some modern tape, the quality would be even better. But centrifugal force takes a while to stop. So there he goes. I'll track it. What is that? Oh, tractor's finished. Oh, well, too many copyrights. So what do you reckon? Nice machine, eh? It's tell you what it is, it's a Revox G36. Now, the only thing I need to have a look at, I've got to take this top off, the plastic top, and have a look at that counter. It's not working. There's a long belt going from here all the way around there somewhere, long belt, and I don't know if it snaps or sometimes these little counters break down. But if it's broken down, oh well, no big deal. But it's just a beautiful machine. I mean, these sell for over £500 in England, all working like this. You know, you can get cheaper ones that are not working, that are collect only, but these are really heavy as well. These weigh about 45 pounds. That's damn heavy. There's a little slight noise in the motor. I can hear it now. Actually, you can hear that. Because when I got it, it wasn't even turning. I tried to press play, it wasn't going. And the motor was actually seized up. So I've been putting oil in it, and it worked sort of first time, but it's a bit noisy. I don't know if the bearings need changing. There's a bearing at the bottom. A bit like a car bearing on the wheel, you know, you've got bearings. I can hear that now. It quietens down sometimes. Anyway, it's working. So the way I look at things, if it ain't fixed, don't break it. The other way around, oh my God. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Oh, God almighty. Anyway. But you never know, that noise might stop. I'll see how it goes. I'll see how the oil, see if the oil seeps in. It takes a while to seep in. It's a massive motor on these things. Look at that, I can feel the breeze from here. It's like a fan. Oh, my God, it takes ages to stop. Look at that. It's the weight of these tapes. Well, the reels, you know, big heavy reels, these. They're metal, aren't they? So it's more centrifugal force than the little plastic ones. So there we go. Let's play it again a little bit. Oh, same track. I tell you what, you should hear it from here. It sounds really sweet. And that's only through these little crappy, sorry about the junk, but it's a workshop, you know. Little Technic speakers and the little Chinese amp. That's the one I use for the doing the Elvis stuff. Look behind there, hiding behind there. It's a crappy amp, really, but it still sounds good, this machine. Now that motor, and it's just that motor noise. Oh, that sounds better now. Oh well, I'm going to leave on for a bit and see how it goes. Let the oil seep right down, because it's got a long shaft and it's got to roll all the way down to the bottom and lubricate the bottom bearing. That's where the bearing is, right at the bottom. So I'm not sure if there's a top bearing, but I know there's one at the bottom somewhere. Oh, it's quiet in there. That's how it should sound. And apparently this machine, when I picked it up, the guy said, well, I said to him, when was it used last? He said, oh, around about the 70s. I thought, what? About 1975 or something like that. So no wonder that it wasn't even turning the motor. God. So there we go. This is a Revox G36. It's got a slight little crack there, I just noticed, on the thing. The plastic. I didn't notice that before. Very slight. Could be due to all the heat inside the valves, you know, the tubes. I don't know if you can see it. Very fine. No big deal. So there we go. It looks lovely with the big reels, doesn't it? If you put the little plastic ones, it doesn't look as good. Well, it looks good, but it doesn't look as good as the studio reels. Oh, there we go. All right then, guys, you enjoy your day, and I'm going to upload this to YouTube. And I just hope it's not shaky, because when I was holding it in one hand, it was a bit wobbly. I need to have a cup of tea. I've got a cup of tea ready with lots of sugar. As I said, I've only had one little plate of spaghetti today, and that was about 12 o'clock. And it's 6 o'clock now, nearly. So I better eat. All right then, talk to you later. I hope you enjoy this little video, and I shall talk to you later. Bye for now.